Hello and welcome to this final boss fight live stream of Minecraft. My name is John and I am here once again alone for a solo Minecrafting. Chris has to get up early tomorrow morning for work. Hey Pendragon, how you doing this evening? I'm here alone. I'm here alone with you guys. I've got a little bit of work that eating an ice lolly sounds good to me. Got a little bit of work to show you guys what I've been doing in the last week off between sessions. Hey, Shern. So, I finished up building the conveyor belt system. So, this system is now fully finished, and this is the final mechanism that we are going to be making that I'm going to set up this evening. And this is going to allow us to build the applied energistics controller, which means we finally get into AE2. And apparently I have completed the challenge High Levels of Stress, which is very accurate. Overstress a furnace engine? Jeez, yeah, that is a high level of stress. Let's turn something down here, shall we? But in finishing that bit of conveyor belt off and placing the last three deployers down here, this system proved too much for that single windmill to handle. So I added this conveyor belt so that the furnace engine here that was providing our high speed power over to this section of contraptions was now powering, or assisting, adding to the power of the windmill and allowed this to keep running. But I noticed in some testing I did that we were having a problem keeping up with the demands of the Stirling dynamo that was powering new things I added over at the bakery. So over here I've added a phytogenic insulator that creates wheat much quicker than our farm does upstairs, and means that we have a very, very, very good supply of wheat here. In fact, we are now voiding wheat, and I can possibly just turn this off for the moment. You need a high level to run again. But that means that we've got a nice backstuff of the mutton wraps. We've actually backstuffed on the silver coins. It does mean that if I take any mutton wraps out, one of these jumps straight into action to refill it, which is very interesting to see, especially if I take out some of the silver coins. Because suddenly an awful lot of mutton wraps get made. It's very noisy suddenly. But it just works. There's like backstuffing up here as well of massive amounts of bread. But unfortunately, that was eating more charcoal than we were making with a single furnace. So I've added another furnace, or another four, five furnaces. The problem is, that is now eating, that was then eating the wood faster than our wood farm was making it, and it still is. I upgraded our wood farm to be significantly larger, but also not directly in the path of where we walk on a regular basis. And it still doesn't quite handle what we need for these furnaces to keep running. It is now doing a pretty good job, but I think there are a couple of things that I can tweak to make this better. One is actually, now that I've got a massive amount of wheat, what I think I'm going to do for the moment is take that phytogenic insulator out from here, and if we need another one, I will make another one. But you can come out and I'll just take away this piping as well. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to pop this on the magmatic dynamo line, getting us saplings. See, if I just run this. Little further along. I can put the insulator here. Do we have any saplings? Need the water. Oh no, I've got the piping here, don't I? I should be able to just hook pipe your augments. You did. Did you realize that you had an ability to output to the top? You didn't. Oh, that is not fast. Can I phytogrow? Cool. That should speed it up a little bit. At least for a while. And then I just need one more silver. Do I have any ender dust? Not enough. That's okay, we've got an infinite amount of it, just not in the system right now. hopefully with applied energistics, we will have a better plan of getting all of these different disparate resources together. Which is something that, as nice as Chris's, storage accessor system is, and we have been using it all of this time to great success, one thing it doesn't handle particularly well is an ability to have external storage. You can pump into it and pump out of it, but not as easy as applied energistics in some cases. Do I have a chest? Ah, yes, I may have cheated in some die for this. Pay no attention. Oh, that's a lot. That's very nice. So if I tell it it's not allowed to extract, extract oak saplings, then they should just sit in there. And then if you pull and push to the top, an auto input output. You should. Yeah, keep saplings in here. The only problem is going to be if this brown, brown, brown ender chest ever fills up with saplings, which will take it a while. Don't think that's going to a massive problem. I hope. Right, let's sleep through this night and get controller or get the next set of mechanisms being built. And so that is going to need us to build the flash drive, which needs one of you, then a cobalt and an iron. And then this filters the last one of these. And well, before I make a big mistake and plumb something else into those. Right, the other thing is, printed silicon. So you and you are filtered to this. Have the pipes. Pipes can go down to there. And then I just need to make another ender chest. So that should be enough silver by now. I need 8 silver. Eight of you. And the ender dust. And then I just need a 8 of the Invar level doohickeys. And I need an ender casing. Ender casing. We out of obsidian? This should be blue, blue, blue. You are going to just sit here. You are going to get a stack limiter to limit to one stack, and we just need, don't need a fancy extractor for this one. Boop. Oh, No, I should have colored you before putting things in. My bad. Let's get those out. They're expensive. We have infinite of them, but they're expensive. And they're now getting extracted over here. Just gonna swap that out to a bigger extractor. And you do have a downgrade. Excellent. I did plan ahead for that. So now just waiting for it to catch up with everything. But we have the calculation mechanisms, which means I can tick this off. And then we need to build the EMI controller, which needs a Fluix casing. Fluix casing is lead. Lead plate. Oh, interesting. And then find out if we have enough calculations. Oh, yeah. We have an ME controller. Welcome to the networking switchboard era. Let's see, how are we going to do with calculation? 16! And then 1 to 5 Fluix, 2 Fluix, 4 lead plates. Not bad. Speed that up a bit. Pop those away. We got the ME controller. So it just wants us to hold one of these. One of these. And one of these. And then that's that quest complete. And just one each of these. And that's Express Circuitry 2 finished. So what is not ticked here? Ah, that's not ticked here. Nope. Is there more of this? With calculation mechanisms, the factory enters the digital age. Instant material energy conversion, ME. revolutionizes item and fluid logistics for both the assembly lines and personal use. At this point, all of the tools necessary to facilitate space travel have become accessible. Might as well start a countdown. Oh, it is time to press the button for the last chapter. Divide by digital. Welcome to the final chapter of the journey, building the data center. What does this entail? Thousands of numeric calculations. That doesn't sound fun. But do not fear, as an inventor, you will let your creation do all the work for you, as usual. Cast the combined logic of all of your calculation mechanisms into two digits, from which you can calculate eight others through a series of crafting operations. A digital ME system is recommended for managing logistics, although not strictly required. So, yeah, basically, this is the final tier. We're on to the finale. But that's not... Well, I mean, that is the end. That's how finales work. But we're not near that point yet. There's a lot of maths to do. There's a lot of building to do. And also, I don't want to really start that without Chris being around. So what I am going to do is check and see how our wood is faring. We actually are getting a backstuffing of wood now, which means that a combination of this not requiring a massive amount of wood anymore. Come on. Here we go. Yep. So I think this was requiring a lot of wood, and that probably calmed down a bit. And the fact that we now have a decent supply of wood coming in from magmatic generation. As I thought, that's going to be a problem. Didn't think it was going to be a problem that soon, but that's going to be a problem. I don't really have a great solution for it. Well, I do actually, don't I? I just take this drawer out from here. And I take it over here. And I just put... the drawer there, and instead of... you just input from the top. You export to the top, input from that side. And then you have... give you a medium tier extractor. Specifically for saplings. And then any saplings that you get will either go into there or into this drawer, which voids them. And that works. So one thing I'm thinking is that for the finale, we need to do a lot of maths, we need to do a lot of applied energistics, and that's going to require us to have another building, I think. But I want to have a space where we can run cabling to our current setups and have things that run to our current facilities and draw items from them. And I'm wondering about suggesting to Chris this mountain as hollow this out as a base of operations, as our computer hub, because it works, I think it works quite well to be able to tap into these drawers and these drawers and also these machines. But I guess something that I can do quickly is get started with some applied energistics. And I wanted to check oak trim. If the oak trim still works to connect drawers, to make a drawer network. Because if it does, that will make the life of connecting these drawers to an AE network a lot easier. Oak trim, boop. You would be literally one piece of oak trim short, wouldn't you? And then I need, is it a zinc machine? Got a zinc casing. What do I need for the zinc machines? It is the infernal mechanisms. Oh, let's hope I don't make another nether portal while Chris isn't here. Right, so zinc machine. And a diamond. So in theory, I lock that, everything connected to it becomes locked, and everything. Yes! So they do work. Excellent. That means I can just run oak trim along the back here. Just have to be careful about picking up any of the resources that fall onto the goodbye forever. Okay. So that should get all the drawers now. So if I unlock you. Nope. Were you just never locked? Or are you too far? Are you too far? Can I move this closer? What if I put you here? So there's two that way, one that way. Pop you there. All the drawers are locked. You're still locked. You're all still locked. You're locked. But none of you are. Okay, that's too far that way now. Can't get them all, can I? What is the range of a drawer controller? Okay, that unlocked that. Now they're all unlocked. If I click that again, you're locked, you're locked. Oh, yes. That just reaches. Okay, so if I get a. So, how do I make an external storage? External storage bus. text store. No. Storage bus. I need an interface. So I need, I'm gonna guess, two of these. And I'm gonna need a, oh dear, laser. One of you and one of you to make the formation calls. And no, that was the formation core again. The annihilation core is the copper dude. So you and you. And then I want to make a storage bus. So I need an interface. And then, do I have the pistons prepared? Maybe. Well, I've got a sticky piston apparently. I don't have much of a network. But it's a start. How do I make Fluix cable? That's going to be a big one. Oh, right. I need the pure crystals. Drop a Fluix seed. No, I can just do this. The Fluix seeds can come from mechanically crafting. Okay, so I need to sleep through the night. That's what I need to do. First things first, let's sleep through the night. Then we're going to get crystals. So aim to get crystals and then wrap it up. Boop, 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 boop. Put this all the way. I need a mechanical crafter. Which needs a brass. I look forward to being able to auto-craft these soon. And then turn that into a brass machine. And then I believe it was saw that into, nope. Crafting table. Have one of those, convenient. Let's use some of this space. Because we've got Surtis. Do we have any Fluix? We do have some Fluix. And Nether Quartz. So we've got three types of quartz. And that's usually used in a lot of this applied energistics. And I believe that I believe that we can mill it. So pure Syrtis quartz, we can turn into Syrtis seeds with the mechanical crafter. Yes. And then that we just put water onto it. And that makes two of them. So actually, I'm going to put these up one. And aim them down. And get some drawers. And get some trim to make some drawers. And then I can just get a cog wheel. And a couple of shafts. And a belt. And then, can the mechanical arm place on the crafter? I think it can, can't it? Am I doing that out? Just laser. Are you placing on a crafter? Or do you place. I basically want this set up again. Yeah. Gonna need a few depots. Gonna need a few more than that. For that system, and then yep. So each of you are going to get a depot, and then we'll have depots like so. Maybe actually, no, we'll go one further out. You are going to be arms. Arms. I need arms. ones do I get for one machine? Is it one? Yeah. So you are going to take from there, place there, and there. And then I just need to rotate that somehow. It's going to be a gearbox. We all know it's going to be a gearbox. But I need another arm first. Need another two, technically. So that is 16 of you. And another brass to crush. To make some brass casings. To make two more arms. And you are going to take from there and place there and there. And you are going to take from there and place there and there. And you are all going to be set forced round robin so you don't accidentally place two on the same thing. And then if I get the gearbox, we're gonna need it to be vertical. And then we're gonna need another cog. Wheel like so. And then we're going to need funnels. Andesite funnels will be better because we don't need them to be smart. Sounds about right. So that you, you, and you output. And then I need six spouts and lots of water. Oh, that's a bad sound. Is that coming through on the stream? Sure hope not. Casing. Probably should have got another one because I'm going to need six copper machines. I need more copper machines than I'm making at the moment, is I believe the case. This needs a bucket, doesn't it? No, not bucket. How do I make a spout? Hopper. Definitely need more copper machines. Two more coppers worth of copper machines, if my count is correct. Another 24 and a side doohickeys and another 48 rubber, which I probably have in the system. I do. That's very convenient. And then I need four hoppers, so I need another three hoppers. Can I get water from? Do I just need to pump some water from here? Nothing says I can't. Aqueous. I need another copper machine, don't I? Of course I do. Of course I do. You and you, and then copper casing turns into copper machine, and you and a bucket turn into an, oh dear, you and a bucket turn into an aqueous accumulator, which gets us even more water. As long as I grab two other buckets of water, of course. Ah. Well. Sorry, Chris. No, I want that. This level is going to be the aqueous. Yes. Because then the pipe can go here and I can put the floorboards back in. And it sort of maybe looks like it still works. But I need a pump. Not a pumpkin. And let's grab these two cogs to go here and here. Shaft, and I have belts. Oh, that is hideous. Let's not do that. That's also right in front of these. Need some more cogs. Okay, if we get more pumps, we get more water. If we get more water, we make more crystals quicker. Overstressed. Damn it, we're overstressing all the systems. What is this running on? Do we have a... little bit slower. Still works. Actually, do this above rather than below, and then we should be able to clear up some of this horrendous pipe work. Yeah, let's actually keep moving this. Can they reach to here? So you are going to take from here, and you are going to place here and here. Removed you to range limitation. So that is right on the edge. And you're all going to be forced round robin. Forced round robin. And then we're going to get the spouts back. Nope, not place the spouts. Not do whatever the hell that was. Aqueous can go here. And second water bucket. May have washed some of the vines away. They'll spread back out. Actually, if I put the pumps... No, they should... And then make sure these are all facing down. Excellent. Sort of. There we go. Why aren't you filling? Why are all the others filling and you aren't filling? Well, what the hell did you just manage to do there? Hate working with water in this pot. I mean, I guess that works. So the next question is, can I do this? That is all working. So then I just need oak trim to get the drawers. And I need pipes. And we'll just turn that connection off and that connection off. And then you'll be an extractor allowed nether. You'll be an extractor allowed fluix, and you'll be an extractor allowed Certus. And then key. Ding, ding, ding. And then I just need to work out how to run the pipes. Oh, what if I run them up there? I need some more pipes. You go in the middle and like that. Yeah, it's a little tight. And if I just turn off those connections. And so you retrieval the pure fluix. And you and you, you retrieval nether, and you retrieval certus. And so this should be unlimited crystals. Excellent. And so I can just put these away. Oh, I've got unlimited crystal. It's going to take a little while to build up, but it will build up. What I might want to do is run, though, just run a thing so that those these draws aren't here. I maybe want to turn them around. But I'll look into doing that between this episode and next, or maybe in the next episode. But with unlimited crystals, we should be able to make a fairly good AE network, which should allow us to automate a lot of things. I'm looking forward to being able to automate a lot of little things that require us to like run around and pick up 8 items over there and so many other items over there, and just sort of move all of that into something that the computer just handles for itself. Oh yeah, it looks like we're not hurting for wood anymore at the moment. Hopefully that also keeps up between sessions. But I think for now, I'm going to say thank you guys so much for watching. If you haven't done so already, please do hit that follow button. It's a great way for you guys to know we go live. A completely free way that you can support us on the channel. We do still have about 10 days left now of September, which means that if you subscribe to us or to any other Twitch account, you get a bit of a discount. It's a great way to support the streamers you enjoy watching. It helps them do what they do. We are going to be at MCM October at the end of October, surprisingly, in London. If you haven't got your tickets yet, there is still time to pick up the daily tickets. The weekend tickets, the weekend ticket bundle has sold out, but you can still buy Friday, Saturday, and Sunday individual tickets. We have a D&D game that we're going to be running on the Saturday of the convention, so stay tuned for more details about that in the coming weeks. But for now, we're going to also have a quick look at what's coming up this week. Tomorrow night, Richard is back for the finale of Monster of the Week, where the group will be presumably dealing with another Monster of the Week. On Wednesday or Friday this week, we're going to get a group together for some GTA, finishing off the prison break heist that we tried last time. And hopefully that will go a little bit better. On Thursday, and probably other days this week, Angel is going to be over on Genshin Impact, because that game has taken over their lives. And then on Sunday this week, we'll be back with Waterdeep Dungeon of the Mad Mage as the group continue to make their way through the drow-infested third level of the dungeon. Let's see how that goes for them, and let me double check who is live at the moment, because I think somebody is live that I want to raid into. Yeah, we're going to raid into Rebels playing some Return to Monkey Island, because it's been quite a while that they've been waiting for an ability to return to Monkey Island. Go give them some love. We'll see you guys again real soon. For now, so long. Bye, guys.